Hey, Cagesider fans, welcome back to our show. And man, we're so excited here for Canelo, Triple G. And when you're talking about voices in boxing and in MMA, this guy right here is one of the very best. He's multilingual. He can do it all for you. He does so many different shows all over the world. Our good friends, Ray Flores, thank you so much for joining us here at Cagesiders.
Angelo, it's a pleasure, man. Oh, man, we talk on the phone. We see each other at events, but it's a pleasure to join you guys on camera here on Cagesiders.
Now, we want to get your thoughts, because you're here in Vegas, Canelo Triple G. How do you see this playing out, man?
I think it's going to be a great fight because you have Gennady Golovkin, who's been wiping out everybody, taking on Canelo Alvarez, who's grown so much since the defeat at the hands of Floyd Mayweather. As you look at it, both guys, I think, are still in the primes of their careers. For people that are saying that Gennady Golovkin's old, I think they are so far off. Daniel Jacobs is just an amazing middleweight, and he pushed Gennady Golovkin to the limit. Canelo Alvarez has demonstrated his power, knocking out Amir Khan, finished off Liam Smith, went ahead and beat up Chavez Jr. So on Saturday night, I think we get a very special show.
Wow. Well, special is what we're all looking for. Oscar De La Hoya mentioned Hearns Hagler. I'm kind of thinking that it was going to be, when I was speaking with people like a Gareth Davies and a Lance Pugmire, I was telling them, I'm thinking it's going to be more like a Leonard Hagler. How do you see it, though? Do you see it as it kind of stretches out, or do you see it as a war?
No, I don't think it. I think it'll be a war in spurts, but let's be honest. Come on, let's pump the brakes. Let the fight happen before we call it Hagler Hearns. It is, let's, you know, those guys are legends. These guys, they have a ways to go. It will be a very good fight. I see this, as you mentioned, Angela, this is why you're very smart when it comes to the business. I think it is more like a Leonard and Hagler matchup, because you have Hagler, Gennady Golovkin, who has just been so dominant. And you kind of see already in the open workouts where Canelo Alvarez in L.A. showing that quick hand speed. So in my opinion, it reminds me of that of Sugar Ray Leonard. Is he going to try to pull the Sugar Ray where 30 seconds to go and then whack, 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 you know, he tries to go ahead and impress the judges? I think that's what we might be in store for coming up on Saturday.
Now, you see why I love this guy. He even points out the whole 30-second, which was a very famous thing that they talk about whenever they talk about that Hagler-Leonard fight, which I still, by the way, Ray, I still believe that Hagler actually won that fight. Sorry. Sorry, Ray. We love you, but I just thought Hagler did pull it off.
And he also did it against Tommy Hearns, if you remember, as well. So he did him in both fights.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Now, when you think in your head, and for all the Latino fans out there that are watching, why do they like Golovkin so much? What is it about Golovkin that all the Latino fans really gravitate towards?
Because he fights with a come-forward style. I mean, the guy, he goes and makes sure, because he wants to focus in on the Hispanic fan base. And he has a fan base out in Eastern Europe, but look, he's gone. When he fights in L.A., fight fans on the West Coast, everywhere, they're very smart. But especially there, they sort of gravitate towards him. And then he does that extra mile. He tries to learn Spanish a little bit. He has that smile. He doesn't talk much. He just brings his best time in, time out. That's why I'm Mexican, and I like the guy a lot. So that just goes to show you. And my guy was Julio Cesar Chavez, greatest of all time. Sorry, Ali. Sorry, Mayweather. Everybody else. Chavez Jr., the man, et cetera, et cetera. But talking about Golovkin, he makes the effort to really sort of please the Mexican fight fans, and he fights aggressive. You got to love that.
So putting you on the spot.
Yeah.
Last thing. Your official pick.
I think Canelo will bring a heck of an effort, but at the end of the day, until he gets beaten, I cannot bet against Gennady Golovkin. Triple G has been dominant for so long, and until I see it happen, I will not believe it. Mayweather was 50-0. I didn't think anybody could beat him. It didn't happen. Gennady Golovkin, he's been dominant. He's been wrecking people. I think he does the exact same thing to Canelo Alvarez. I think we see a stoppage late in the fight on Saturday night.
There you go, Cagesider fans. If you don't want to listen to me, definitely listen to him. This guy knows what he's talking about, Mr. Ray Flores. Thank you so much for joining us.
Angelo, always a pleasure. You know what? You better listen, Angelo, because the man knows fighting like nobody's business. Do yourself a favor. Listen to him. Educate yourselves. School's in session on Cagesiders.